Here I am today to tell you about a screening procedure for breast cancer you'll be very curious to know about. Yes, you guessed it right, mammography. I'll be sharing with you 5 things you need to know about mammography. Please watch the full video to know what it is, how and why it is done, and much more. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Womb to Super Womb. I am Dr. Samata with you on this journey towards a healthier you. In my last video, I spoke about perimenopausal period by popular demand. I hope you liked and shared it with your near and dear ones. If you haven't watched it yet, please find the link in the description box below. If you are here for the first time and you like what you learn, then please subscribe to my channel at the end of this video and click the bell icon to get the latest updates. So let's start. First of all, what is mammography? Mammography is an imaging procedure that uses low-dose X-rays to visualize inside the breast. It basically helps in the early detection of benign and malignant breast diseases in women. So, it is both a screening as well as a diagnostic tool. A screening mammography is carried out in a woman who is at risk of developing cancer, but until then has not shown any symptoms of cancer. This is a precautionary investigation to catch the disease at the earliest and nip it in the bud. While a diagnostic mammography is carried out when a woman starts showing signs and symptoms of breast disease and it becomes crucial to find the cause of the disease. It is also done in women whose previous screening mammography results turned out abnormal. How is mammography done? The woman is undressed from the waist up and asked to stand in front of the mammography machine, which is a special type of X-ray machine. The radiologist or technician will place the breast on a plastic plate. Another plate will press from the top against it. So, the two plates will now flatten the breast from both sides and hold it in position while the X-ray is being taken. At this point, the woman may feel pressure or mild discomfort, especially when it is done a few days before her periods start. But it is normally not painful. Once this is done, the same procedure is repeated on the other breast. If it becomes painful at any point during the procedure due to compression, be sure to inform the technician. I would like to give you a few tips before getting a mammography. First, don't wear a dress. Rather, wear a top or a t-shirt since it will be convenient for you to undress your upper body till the waist for the test. Second, don't wear talcum powders or deodorants or perfumes as they could appear as calcifications or white spots on the mammogram. Third, avoid scheduling an appointment a few days prior or during your periods, as breasts are tender and slightly swollen during this time of the cycle. Fourth, if you have any symptom for which you have been suggested a mammography, describe the symptom in detail to the one who is performing the test and make the details available to your radiologist. What are the benefits of mammography and why is it important? Screening mammography is beneficial in early detection of all types of breast cancers, including small tissue growths in the milk ducts called ductal carcinoma in situ. Mammography minimizes the risk of deaths due to this cancer. Breast cancer is one such cancer which is curable with 99% survival rate when identified at an early stage so that it becomes easier to treat with appropriate medical and surgical treatment for it. So, mammography is an effective screening tool against breast cancer when performed according to the recommendations. In addition to that, it is also helpful to detect benign breast diseases such as fibroadenoma, fibrocystic disease of the breast. So, whenever you have localized pain in the breast, that is at one spot in the breast, or spontaneous discharge from the nipple, lump in the breast, or any kind of swelling in the breast with or without pain, change in breast size and firmness, thickening of the breast skin, nipple changes, the doctor will suggest you to get a mammography mainly to rule out cancer. When should you get a mammography test and how often? According to the latest recommendations, a woman having an average risk should undergo mammography every 1 to 2 years starting from the age of 40. If she has missed this test in her 40s, then it is advisable to get a mammography at the earliest. And this should be continued routinely until she is 75. Now you will ask me what I mean by average risk for breast cancer. For that, you need to understand who are at high risk. So, a woman who has a family history of breast cancer or ovarian cancer or any other inherited types of cancer, or if she has undergone some kind of radiation treatment in her younger days, then she is at high risk. And all others are at average risk. Please know that women who are at high risk of developing breast cancer should be extra cautious and should undergo mammography and breast MRI every year right from the age of 30. What are the limitations of mammography? Like any other screening test, even mammography can have false positive and false negative test results. So, in such cases, your doctor may advise you to go for repeated mammographies or additional tests like breast sonography or MRI and biopsy to find the root cause of the abnormality. Remember, even though you will take these recommendations and undergo mammography routinely, this is not an alternative to the monthly breast self-examination and yearly clinical breast examination, which I will be talking about in my upcoming videos. If you found this video informative, please like, comment, share, and subscribe if you haven't. Stay healthy and stay tuned. Thank you.